Hello students, we are doing chapter number 11, triangles and its properties, exercise 11.2. In last video we have discussed till question number 5 and today we will start from question number 6. So first part is, one figure is given. From this figure we have to find out the value of x and y. So when triangle is given, you can see here we can name this triangle A, B and C. Now you can see this angle. Angle A will be equal to X. Reason we have to give here, vertically opposite angle. These two lines are intersecting each other. So this angle and this angle will be equal. Similarly, angle B also will be equal to X. Same reason, vertically opposite angle. Now third angle C, which is given equal to y, that one also will be equal to x, because y and x are vertically opposite angle. So these all the three interior angles are equal to x. Now we can use angle sum property here. By angle sum property, angle A plus B plus C will be equal to 180 degree. So all the three angles are x is equal to 180 degree. 3x is equal to 180. 3, if you shift another side, it will go for division and you will get x value is 60 degree. And as we know, y and x are equal. So y, because y is equal to x, therefore the y value will be 60 degree. Next, sixth main second part, figure is given here. In this figure, three internal angles are there, x, x and y, and one exterior angle is given, 125. So first we will use your linear pair property. With the help of that we will get the value of x. So x plus 125 is equal to 180 degree. We are using here linear pair angles. All the properties compulsory you have to mention. So x value will be 180 minus 125, which is equal to 55 degree. After getting x value, now in this triangle we will use angle sum property. By angle sum property, x plus y plus x is equal to 180 degree. X value already we have find out 55 degree. So y plus 110 is equal to 180 degree. And y will be equal to 180 minus 110, which is equal to 70 degree. Next, to third part of question number 6. In this figure, you can see here we have two triangles. It is the combination of two triangles. One triangle is this one and another triangle is in this one. So first you have to see in which triangle we have more information. So you can see here in triangle ACD we know two angles and third we have to find out. In another triangle only one angle is given and one we have to find out. It means in this triangle ACD we have more information. So we will start from there. In triangle ACD, by angle sum property, x plus 50 plus 70 is equal to 180 degree. 50 and 70, after addition we will get 120 degree. So x value will be 180 minus 120 is equal to 60 degree. Now we got x value. After this we can use now exterior angle property. This is the exterior angle and this exterior angle will be equal to the sum of opposite interior angle. So in triangle BACD, sorry ABC, by exterior angle property, थर्टी सिक्स प्लस वाई विल बी इक्वल टू एक्स, थर्टी सिक्स प्लस वाई विल बी इक्वल टू 60 degree. सो वाई विल बी 60 degree माइनस 36, वाई वैल्यू विल बी 24 degree. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, फर्स्ट पार्ट. इन द गिवन फिगर डी ई एंड बी सी आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर. These two lines are parallel to each other. Same type of arrow means these two lines are parallel. We have to find out the value of x here. So first we will use the properties of parallel line. After that we will find out the value of x. Now with the help of properties of parallel line, this angle will be equal to 50 degree. Angle B will be equal to 50 degree by corresponding angle properties. Corresponding angles. Next, if we talk about this angle, we have to find out this angle also. So this angle, if we take, suppose it is y, then y plus 95 will be equal to 180 degree, because these two are linear pair angles. Linear pair angles. So y value will be 180 minus 95 equal to 85 degree. So now in this triangle ADE, in triangle ADE by angle sum property, x plus y plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. Y value also we have calculated, 85 plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. By 80 plus 150 will be 135 equal to 180. So x value will be 180 minus 135 equal to 45 degree. Next question number 7th B part. In the given figure we have angle P is equal to 3y and we have to find out the value of x and y. Angle P means this angle is given 3y. We have to find out the value of x and y. Now to find out the value of x and y, find the value of x, we can use exterior angle property. By exterior angle property, x plus 60 will be equal to exterior angle, means equal to 100 degree. So x value will be 100 minus 60, 40 degree. Now in triangle PQS we can use angle sum property. In triangle PQS by angle sum property, y plus 3y plus 100 will be equal to 180 degree. Y plus 3y will become 4y and 100 you can shift another side. 180 minus 100. So 4y is equal to 80 degree. So y will be 80 by 4. Do the cancellation, 20 times it will go. So y value will be 20. Degree. Next is 7th C part. In the given figure, find the size of each lettered angle. So letter here given XYZ, we have to find out the value of XYZ. First we will name this triangle ABC and DE. Now you see, if we see this big triangle ABC, in this big triangle we know two interior angle and third is unknown. It means we can find out easily X. In triangle ABC by angle sum property, x plus 80 plus 52 will be equal to 180 degree. So 80 plus 52 will be 132 equal to 180 degree. X value will be 180 minus 132, which is equal to 48 degree. After this, now to find out the value of y, we can use exterior angle property. This is the exterior angle and these two are opposite interior angle. So by exterior angle property, x plus y is equal to 143. X value is 48 degree plus y is equal to 143 degree. So y will be 143 degree minus 48 degree, which we will get equal to 95 degree. Then to find out the value of z, we can use here linear pair property. By linear pair angles, z plus 143 is equal to 180 degree. So z is equal to 180 minus 143 equal to 37 degree. Next question number 8. One of the angle of a triangle measure 80 degree and other two angles are equal. Find the measure of each of the equal angle. In triangle we know 23 angles are there. So one angle is given here 80 degree and other two are equal. So let equal angles are x and x. Because both are equal, so we will take x and x. So by angle sum property, the sum of all three angles will be 180 degree. It means x plus 80 is equal to 180 degree. X plus x will become 2x plus 80 is equal to 180 degree. 80 we can shift another side, it will go for subtraction. So 2x is equal to 100 degree. X will be 100 by 2. 2 shift another side. So x value will be 50 degree. It means the equal angles are 50 degree. Next question number 9. If one of the angle of a triangle is 60 degree and other two angles are in the ratio of 2:3. Find these angles. So first angle is given 60 degree, for other two ratio is given. So let other two angles are 2x and 3x. If it is given in ratio, we have to take like this. After this, we can use angle sum property. By angle sum property, plus 3x plus 60 degree. These are the three angles which will be equal to 180 degree. 2x plus 3x will become 5x plus 60 degree is equal to 180. So 5x will be equal to 180 minus 60 equal to 120 degree. So x will be 120 by 5. 5 2s are and 4s are 24 degree. So x we got here 24 degree. So angles will be, first is 2x means 2 into 24, 48 degree. And second angle is 3x means 3 into 24, which will be equal to 72 degree. Next question number 10. If the angles of a triangle are in the ratio of 1:2, 2:3, find the angles and classify the triangle into two different ways. So all the three angle ratio is given 1:2, 2:3. So let angles are 1x, 2x and 3x. Now we will use angle sum property. By angle sum property, the sum of three angles should be 180 degree. So So 1 plus 2 plus 3, we will get 6x is equal to 180 degree. So x will be 180 divided by 6 is equal to 30 degree. So x value is here 30 degree. So angles will be, first is x which is equal to 30 degree. Second one is 2x means 2 into 30 equal to 60 degree. And third one is 3x means 3 into 30 equal to 90 degree. So this angle we have to classify into two different ways. So first of all three angles are different. It means all three sides also will be different. So this is an scaling triangle. And second thing, based on angle we will see. So one angle is 30, one is 60 degree and one is 90 degree. One angle is 90 degree, it means it is a right angle triangle. Next question number 11, can a triangle have three angles whose measure are 65 degree, 74 degree and 39 degree? We will add these angles and we will see whether the sum is coming 180 degree or not. If sum is coming 180 degree, it means triangle is possible, otherwise it is not possible. So we will add, we will find out the sum of angles. 65 plus 74 plus 39. After addition, we will get here 178 degree. Which is not equal to 180 degree. It means triangle is not possible. Second part, 1/3 right angle, 1 right angle and 60 degree. Right angle means 90 degree. So first we will change it into degree. 1/3 of 90 means 330 times it will cancel. It means it is equal to 30 degree. Second one right angle means 90 degree and third is given 60 degree. So 30, 90 and 60, three angles are there. So we will do the sum of angles. 30 plus 90 plus 60 which is equal to 180 degree. So in this case, yes, triangle is possible. Only for 180 degree triangle will be possible. If it is coming more than 180 degree or less than 180 degree, then it is not possible. This exercise has completed here. Hope you understood this exercise. Thank you for watching this video.